What is going on, you guys? This is Zach Soccer Forever. Today, I'm going to be bringing you guys a $700 unboxing PC build, pretty much. I'm going to be unboxing all these things one by one. As you can see, I got everything. I got the motherboard. I got the case. I got the GPU. I got the power supply. I got the CPU. I got the RAM. I got everything. I even got some special lights for this to make it look really, really cool. So, pretty much, I'm going to be going one by one. I'm going to start off from small to the biggest unboxing. So, let's get this started. Alright, you guys, so pretty much I'm going to be unboxing the SATA connector. This is pretty much for hard drives, so you can connect the hard drive to the motherboard. And pretty much I got the red one because I want to make this look pretty cool with red. And red is my second favorite color. My first favorite color is blue. But as you can see here, it comes with two SATA connectors. So right here. As you can see, it just clips on right there. It has a little clip, so it'll lock onto your hard drive and lock onto your motherboard, and then you'll be all set. As you can see, there's a little notch right there, so it only goes in one way, but that is about it. So the next thing that I'm going to be unboxing are the accent lights. I got the red USB and light strips, six light LED light strips. You can put it on your PC, on your keyboard. And it has a little switch, an on and off switch, and it is USB powered, so there's no power supply or anything like that. So we're just going to take this out, and right away, as you can see, you got the cable and you got the LED lights, and that is it. It doesn't come with anything else, pretty much. But we got the USB, and it's a USB 2.0, and then we got the lights itself. It's in a, like, a type of gel style, and you could cut it to shorten it if you want to. I don't see why. And then you got tape on the back, so you could stick it onto any type of case or keyboard, but that's about it for the accent light. Alright, you guys, so pretty much I'm going to be unboxing the Corsair Vengeance LP DDR3. This is a DDR3 8 gigabit 1600 megahertz RAM. Comes with two 4 gigabit RAMs, and it goes to 8. So let's get this right out of the box here. As you can see, you got like a nice little protection so that you won't touch any of the metal plates with your bare hands. Otherwise, you will shock it and you will fuck it up. I swear, you will mess up the RAM. So pretty much, let me just get this right out of the little case. And as you can see, it comes with two. And DDR3 has that little notch right there so that it only goes in one way to the RAM, to the motherboard, so that you know. And it has two notches on the side as well, so that's how you could tell it is a DDR3, and it comes with two of them. So one is a 4 gigabit and that equals to 8. So that is about it. So let's move on to the CPU. So pretty much I got my latex gloves because I do not want to mess up the CPU at all. This was the most expensive thing to buy, and it comes with the CPU and the heatsink. So pretty much I got the Intel Core i7-4790K, and it is an LGA 1150 CPU socket. So you're going to need a motherboard that supports that type of CPU socket, just to let you guys know. So pretty much I'm going to take this right out of the box. And it comes with the heatsink and fan with the pre-thermal paste on it. And it comes with the CPU itself. And let's see what else we got, because I do not remember this whatsoever. Ah, yes, we got the installation instructions. And we got a little other information I totally forgot. Comes with the sticker on the back. You saw a little peek of it so that you can put it on the desktop. But as you can see right here, we got the heatsink and fan. And we got the pre-thermal paste right on it. So there you go. And then we got the cable. It is a 4-pin connector and it has a little notch as well, so it only goes in one way. So there's the heatsink and fan. Heatsink and fan from stock isn't that bad. It helps and it works, so I don't mind that. But we got the CPU as well. Now, do not touch those contact points. I swear, if you touch those contact points, you're gonna mess it up and you're gonna be in big trouble and you're gonna be really pissed off. But pretty much, as you can see right there on the front, it says Intel Core i7. So, and that is pretty much it. I'm not gonna take it out of the little plastic because I really don't want to mess it up. But anyway, that is the unboxing of the heatsink and fan and the CPU. So next, what we're gonna be doing is unbox the GPU. This is the GeForce GT730. It's a 1 gigabit DDR3 GPU. It is pretty nice, and as you can see on the top right, it shows a little bit of the connectors, and then we can see it's a VGA in, HDMI in, and DVI in, and you can see all the key features like Nvidia 3D Vision, NVIDIA CUDA, NVIDIA, what else? We can see that is the fix, I can't even pronounce that technology, but we're gonna unbox this right now. So pretty much I unboxed the wrong side of it, but I got it now. So as you can see, we got the little brackets here. This is to place on the case to specify what type of ports they are, but you should pretty much know what type of ports they are. It's just three little ports, that's it. Then we got the GPU itself in a bubble wrap and an anti-static bag so it will not shock it, and it comes with the disc. Now I do recommend that you go to the manufacturer's website to download the latest driver, because those discs are probably not the latest from the manufacturer. So pretty much we're gonna take the GPU right out of the bag, and we can see right here there's the anti-static bag. It is to protect it so that it will not get shocked. That's why I'm wearing gloves, so that I will not shock any of the components on it, so I'm perfectly safe of touching any of those metal parts, because if I touch it with my bare hands and if I'm near any carpet or wearing a sweater, things like that, it will conduct energy and I will be able to shock it, and then that will mess it up on any type of components. But as you can see here, it says NVIDIA. It is a PCIe port input, and we can see that it has the DVI, the HDMI, and the VGA input, and that's about it. It's not the best looking GPU, but it does the job. So pretty much we are going to be moving on to the power supply. All right, you guys, so I'm going to be unboxing the Corsair CX500 CX series power supply. This is an ATX power supply, and it's very silent, so it says. And as you can see on the back, you can see all the connectors that it comes with, pretty much all the cables in need to power up everything. We got the 20 to 24 pin motherboard power. We got the 4 pin, we got the 6 pin, we got the Molex, we got the SATA connectors. We got all these types of things, and I'll explain them in a later video on how to pretty much do it all. But as you can see here, it comes with the warranty guide, and it comes with the important safety information. As you can see, it comes with the power supply, and it comes with little ties so you could tie it, make it look neat on in the case, so that the airflow would be nice and will be pretty much good airflow, because airflow will be perfect for cooling down the CPU, the RAM, and the GPU. So we're gonna take this right out of the bag. Now it's perfectly safe that you can touch it with your bare hands, because it is all metal, and if you touch metal, then it will take away all the shock that you have on your hands. So pretty much I'm perfectly safe. So pretty much we got the CX500. It's on a nice type of matte black, and it's like a metal type feel with the fan in it. We got the switch, we got the input for the power, and then we got all these cables. They are really thick cables, and you can see we got all the types of cables that I described earlier. So pretty much these are all the cables. These are all for CPU powers, SATA powers, hard drive powers, and motherboard powers, all these types of things. You don't need all of them, just to let you guys know. It's just in case, pretty much. But we're gonna be moving on to the bad boy itself. We're gonna be moving on to the motherboard. This is the MSI Z97S SLI Crate Edition. This looks really cool. I mean, look at that cobra. It's nice and black and white type of motherboard, and you can see on the little bottom it shows the IO overview. Comes with a USB 2.0s, mouse and keyboard input, HDMI, USB 3.0, two of them, Ethernet, LAN, DVI, VGA, and two USB 3.0 as well. Also comes with 6 sets of audio, so you could have the subwoofer, you could have the microphone, you could have the audio, you could have the side audio pretty much. But as you can see, there's the motherboard in an anti-static bag once again, so it will keep everything pretty much protected, because I do not want to mess up the motherboard as well. That's like the second most expensive thing pretty much. But as you can see right here, it also comes with the SATA connectors that I showed, the very first thing that I showed you guys, but I like the red ones. And then as you can see here, we got the back plate. This is to put on the back of the case so that it'll show everything, what type of connectors those things are, and that's gonna be a pain to put on the case. But then we got over here, we got the installation driver on the disc. I do recommend that you go to the manufacturer's website to get the latest drivers. And then we got the pretty much how to install it pamphlet. It shows step by step on how to really install it, but it's very good for those people that don't really know. Then we got the user guide. This is very important, especially for the front panel indicators, so that you will know exactly what type of pins that you need to put them in. And then that is pretty much it. So then where you're going to get the motherboard right out of the anti-static bag, and we're gonna get a closer look at it. I am wearing gloves once again, so I do not shock anything, so I do not mess up anything, so I don't have to go and get buy another one. Pretty much, unless you have a warranty, you could get it back. Just to let you guys know, I bought all these things at Micro Center. Micro Center is the best thing for building your own PC, computing, anything that is electronic based. It has monitors, PC parts, everything that you pretty much need. And I really like my Micro Center. I like it so much better than Best Buy. Best Buy has the equipment, but Micro Center has all the parts, everything separate. So as you can see here, it got nice black and white style, looks really nice. As you can see, we got the PCIe input, we got the CPU socket. This is an LGA 1150 once again, and then we got the little pins for USB, the front panel indicators. Like I said before, we got the SATA inputs, and we also got the RAM input, and we got the 24 pin input to power on the motherboard. And then as you can see over here, I show you guys the ports as well, like I said before. But that is pretty much it of the unboxing of the motherboard. Now we're gonna be moving on to the very last thing, and that is the case. Now pretty much I couldn't unbox the case because my camera couldn't catch everything, but I'm moving around to show you guys what it is. This is a thermal take Versa H22 plus, and it has a USB 3.0, a USB 2.0, a reset button, a power on button, a headphone input, and a mic input. We got two fans on the top as well, and then we got the back, the one on the sides, and then we got the other side, and that one has airflow ventilation pretty much. And then as you can see, if I'm gonna turn this, yes I am, I'm gonna be turning this to the back, you can see we got another fan. We have the ports for opening for the ports, and then we got an opening for the power supply. As you can see, I showed you guys the inside. You can see it also comes with the cables for the fans, for the fan power on, to power on to the motherboard. We also got the HD audio. We got the little cables for all the front indicator lights, the power on buttons, all those types of things. As you can see right there, they are all labeled, so which is good. But like I said, you guys gotta go check out the guide on how, where to exactly put those things. But that is pretty much it for the case. And we got the filter as well for the power supply. Alright you guys, so I hope you guys enjoyed that video of all my unboxings on my $700 PC. It is really cool. I pretty much did every little unboxing, even some accessories like the accent light. The only thing that I didn't get was the hard drive, the DVD drive, and the Windows OS. Because what I did was I got the hard drive from my old PC and I put that into my new PC, and I already had the OS, and I didn't need a DVD drive, so I saved a couple of money from that, which was a plus. And I had all the apps, everything right there, so I didn't have to install everything that I had in my old PC, any type of files, anything like that. I just moved it from my old PC to my new PC, and that was it. So that was a plus, and it saved me a lot of time and money. So I do recommend that you guys go do that. Plus, I was gonna do a how to build PC video, but the area that I'm in, pretty much I wasn't really able to do it. The lighting was off, the camera wasn't that much in focus, it wasn't really that good. Plus I kind of needed a two guy thing, because I would have to maneuver around, try not to hit the camera and things like that. So I couldn't really do it. So I'll leave a link in the description below for some how to PC build from a guy named Austin Evans. He's a really good YouTuber. He does a lot of pretty much PC builds, how to PC builds, a lot cheap PC builds for those of you guys that don't have that much money. So pretty much it goes from around $300 to $4,000 how to PC builds. So I'll leave a link to most of those how to PC builds. They are very similar and they are very good. But hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and Twitch. As always, this is Zach Soccer Forever. I'm out. Peace.
We'll be right back.